Hello learners, my name is Mashamba Doctor here. This is Mathematics and Physical Science Simplified. Today we are going to be learning about algebraic functions, where we are going to be doing parabola. Before we go far, don't forget to subscribe there and also like the video. Before we start, you can see that it's a very, very good topic, parabola. Alright, algebraic functions. Algebraic functions. Alright, we are going to be looking at the graph y is equal to ax squared plus q. Y is equal to ax squared plus q. What are the things that you need to know? You need to know the first thing is the shape of the graph. You must understand the shape of the graph. If the value of a, this one, if a is greater than 0, the graph will be like this. Meaning that the graph, it is what? Smiling. Okay? This is the shape of the graph. Now, if the value of a is less than 0, you must know that the shape of the graph will be like this. So, which implies that the graph, it is what? Sad. See? So, don't forget about these things. And then, the next step that you need to look at is the domain and the range of the graph. What are the domain and the range of this graph? So, every time, the domain of the parabola graph in this type of the graph, it is always x is an element of all real numbers. But what about the range? If the value, if a is greater than 0, every time the range y is greater or equal to q, this q is this number that you have there, you see? But if a is less than 0, the range of the graph y will be less or equal to q. Don't forget about this one. So this is the parabola graph. This graph, like I said, is what? Parabola. This is the parabola graph. Now, when you draw the parabola graph, let's go to step number 3. You look for y-intercept. That's the first thing. Where there's x, you replace by 0. And then, step number 4, what do you do? You look for x-intercept. Where there's y, you replace by 0. Then, how do you find this x-intercept? We factorize. You factorize. Step number 5, you do what? You sketch the graph. These are the things that you have to look for in parabola graph and algebraic expressions. All right, let's go to the example. Let's look at the example on this graph. So you can be able to follow all these steps that I was giving you to draw the graph. Now, e.g., sketch the following graph or function. Now we are given that y is equal to x squared minus 4. Sketch this graph. Y is equal to x squared minus 4. What is the first thing that you need to do? Know the shape. Your a is greater than 0 because a is 1. You expect a shape to be like this. This is the first thing that you have to look for. Now, you look for your domain. See, what is the domain of this graph? X is an element of all real numbers. What is the range of this graph? If a is greater than 0, you know that the graph will be, y will be greater or equal to minus what? 4. This is the range of this graph. Before you draw it, you'll be knowing everything. All right, let's go to the another step. The first step of all these things is what? Y intercept. Where there's x, you put 0 there. Let's replace. Y is equal to 0 squared minus 4. What is the y intercept? Minus 4. You see? Okay? Step number 2. What did we say about step number 2? We are calculating the x intercept. Where there is y, you replace what? 0. You see, this is the graph. Where there is y, we're going to say 0 is equal to x squared minus 4. You see? X squared minus 4 is equal to 0. What did we say here? We factorize. X and x minus 2 and plus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, what are your x-intercepts? X is equal to minus 2, or your other x is what? 2. So these are the y-intercept, x-intercept, domain, and range. With these things, we can be able to draw the graph. Therefore, let's draw the graph here. Let me draw it here. This is your 0 here. This is y-axis. This is x-axis. This is minus 2 plus, and here we have our 2. And then minus 4 somewhere here. See? Remember, you intercept, you put dots. Already, you know the type of the graph. Therefore, you just come and join and extend. See? This is the graph of parabola. When we say draw the graph of parabola, you must draw it like this. This is how we draw the parabola graph. Alright. Let's try to interpret this graph. Let's try to interpret this graph. Okay, want to interpret the graph? E.g., given that f of x is equal to negative 2x squared, let's say this one, plus 18 is drawn below. Now, this is the graph that is drawn below. You see? You see this graph? Let me just try to draw it nicely so that you can be able to see properly. This is the graph. Okay? This is coordinate A, B, C. This is 0, this is x and y. You see? So these are the coordinates that we have. Now, the first thing that I want to do, question number one. Determine the coordinates of A and B. You see? Now, question number two. Determine the coordinates of C. The last question. Write down the domain and range of the graph f of x. You see? These are three questions that I need you to calculate them. The first thing, you can pause the video and try to work it out. And then after that, then you play it, then you will continue together there. Now, let us start with the first one, solution. The first question, determine the coordinate of A and B. You have to start which coordinate is your A, which coordinate is your B. So, where the graph cut the x-axis, that means that coordinate is the x-intercept. Where the graph cut the y-axis, that one is the y-intercept. So A and B, the graph is cutting the x-intercept. So the x-axis. So these are x-intercept. And I said when we calculate the x-intercept, where there is y, f of x, just a nickname. It means y. It's equal to negative 2x squared plus 18. Where there is y, I'll put 0. Minus 2x squared plus 18. You see? Then you divide everything by minus 2. We are solving there. Therefore, we'll get 0 is equal to x squared minus 9. You see? This one, you can be able to factorize it. You get minus 3 and plus 3. So the value of x is 3, or the value of x is minus 3. So these are the x-intercepts. Now, when you look at this graph, your A is on the left, and that's where you get the negative. So meaning that the coordinate of A will be minus 3 is to 0. This 0 is for y. You know this line, y is 0. What about B? 3 is to 0. You see? So we are done with this one. We have calculated the coordinate of A and B. Now, let's go to the coordinate of C. You need to study the coordinates, then you'll be able to interpret the graph. Look at C. What is this C? C is a point where the graph cut the y-axis, meaning that this is y-intercept. So you are going to come and say y is equal to minus 2 into 0 squared plus 18. So y is equal to 18. So meaning that the coordinate here, it will be 0 is to 18. Someone will be asking, why did you start with 0? Every time the coordinate starts with x and the next one is y. Like here, this is x and this is y. Alright, so meaning that we know the coordinate of C, 0 is to 18. Now, write down the domain and the range. Remember class, the domain is always x is an element of all real numbers. The domain of the parabola is always x is an element of all real numbers. And what about the range? What is the range of this graph? You see your a is less than 0, meaning that the range is y is less or equal to 18. See? This is how we interpret the graph of parabola. So that's all. The first thing, you have to draw the graph. The next thing, you have to interpret the graph. Know that the domain of parabola is always x is an element of all real numbers. And the range, it depends on the value of a. So don't forget to subscribe there, and don't forget to click the notification. So thank you so much.